start streaming, and for some reason it must not have started. Well, there, now they're here and life is good. You know, if you want to see this from the very beginning, you really need to see it on Facebook. So hey, last time we talked about the Stamparatus, and my good friend Doodles had her owner call me up, and she told me a little tip, and I'm going to show it to you right now. It's really quick. Hold on one second. Let me go down here to the desk so that you can see it. And she mentioned that when she goes over here, golly, I warned you about those. And I have one magnet over here and one way over there, so it's okay if it goes on that. She said she has a little notebook here that she puts up under it. And so, let's do this. If I have time, I'm going to do two things today. This would be kind of like that notebook. And so wherever you've got your stamp that you are inking up, you're going to want to go and put something solid underneath it so that you get a better press when you're inking up your stamp. Isn't that great? Oh my goodness. I hope my husband's near the phone. Either that or else we use a service called, what is it called? When I think about it, I'll tell you. Anyway, and if one of those robocallers call us, then it goes directly to some recording that tells them, hey, we don't want to talk to you. So, you know, they're just going to tell me that the IRS is after me and that the police will be here shortly. So, you know, hey, that's not a lot to worry about, is it? Okay, so this is the stamp set, and who do we have here? We've got Jeannie. Yes, I will love on Stamper, but you know, the little granddaughter is next door playing with the dog, and so of course Stamper has to be out there and to chaperone everything. Okay, and let's see, there's Jan. Yeah, sad news. We don't deal with sad here today, okay? We do that I go behind the monitor and I have a good cry. So anyway, let's see. And Joni, I haven't seen Joni in a long time. I hope your health is up to snuff, and it must be because you're here. Marcy's here. Yes, half of my Neapolitans are gone, and I've been good. The first night, I pretty much gorged myself. You know, Amy, I don't think I've met Amy before, and so hey, I am so glad you're here. We appreciate all the comments and all the hearts. You know, I would love to think that you love me as much as I love you. On the other hand, that's the only way that Facebook knows that you like being here, okay? So anyway, hey, let's get started so I can do two of these things, and we'll do it this way. How about that? Okay, so this is the stamp set that you are going to want to get. And I hope my husband's not listening right now, but you really need to buy some of those masculine stamp sets and stuff, because statistically, not always, I'm not saying it's more value or anything, but statistically men make more than women, right? And if you are married or you are dating or something, you want the person who's probably contributing the most to your stamp collection. Let's say it that way, okay? So you want to make them a card, and you want to make them feel special. And you know what? That's a good thing anyway, you know, because they're your husband or your significant other, or, you know, and so you want to make them feel special. Or maybe it's your dad, you know? I mean, you want to make them feel special. So having a good collection of masculine stamps is a great thing. And I think, honestly, people don't buy enough greeting stamps, and this has greetings. Okay, so I showed you part of the card on the dog's blog this morning, and this is the card. And it's, for those of you who are demonstrators, it's an easy workshop card. And it's an easy card to mass produce, and we're going to do that today, because we're going to send out, I think, 37 of them in the mail tonight. So there you go. For just a second, I'm going to go and give you a little medical advice. And this includes you. Oh, Virginia's here from Southern California. I'm assuming Chatsworth is in Southern California. You told me last time, I think, but anyway, yeah, I've blinked since then. So yesterday I got blood drawn, and I'm going to see if I can show this to you. This is where they drew the blood, right? That little dot. And this is where the adhesive was. Now, it's not that I'm allergic to the adhesive, but this part over here, I gingerly tore off just a little bit at a time. And then I was over here and I went, well, let me just go and rip it off. Rip! Oh, that's what happens when you rip the adhesive off. So now everybody here is smarter. When you get your blood drawn, gingerly take it off or else get a rip. You know, that's just the way it goes. Yes, we talk about more than stamping here. So let's get started on this card. And now, when I go and mass produce these, I am going to go and score this. But when you don't have the implements nearby, and I do, but I'm not going to anyway. This is 8.5 by 5.5, and I am folding it in half. And see, what I do is I match these corners, and I give it a pinch. And then I turn it over, and I match these two corners, and I give it a pinch, right? And so, see, and now I'm just going to pinch it a little bit in between, but then you still have time for your bone folder to give it a nice good press. And you don't want to dip your bone folder in like this, or I don't like to use this in because it's more apt that I'm going to go in. That's when you're going to make a mark parallel to it. But if I use it, you know, like, here, let me do it from your side. You know, kind of like, just kind of slide it over it, then that's great. And ours are made out of bone, so, you know, they're a lot nicer. So there you go. Now it's done. Let's see. I only made this last night. So, hey, get a piece of paper and a pen out. Oh, yay. Stamper's going to love it. Here, Kathy's here from New York. You know, I'm getting new glasses. They're going to be here. I'm getting new glasses today, regular glasses today, and then I'm getting computer glasses just for when I'm with you, because this is just a little bit, my monitors are just a little bit too far. I mean, I can read everything, but if I want to really concentrate or solve a problem really quickly, then I have to go and you know, kind of look. And and when I put these on, it's just too close. So but it's funny because the computer glasses for this cost more than the regular glasses, which have more bells and whistles, right? Because I bought them someplace else. You know, I did, the computer glasses, I had the optometrist make them because I think she had a better idea of what I wanted. And it costs almost as much to have my husband's progressives and my progressives done as it was to make those computer glasses so I could see you better. So, so back to this. This is 5 inches by 1.5. And this is 5.25 inches by 1 5/8. And I did that because I did not, if you notice this, it doesn't have the standard border all around the edge. I only wanted it on this side. And the reason for that is because, you know, if there's a gallon quart ounce idea that it's not an idea, it's a theory, I guess you could call it, that makes it to where if you have a gallon of one color, which is a tranquil tide, and you have a quart of another color, which I would say would be the which is it? See, it's we're getting a little bit too much, and then an ounce of a third color. So if I put the, it's already that, you know, you have almost as much vanilla as you do Night of Navy. And I didn't want to have any more vanilla on there, but I did want this corner. I just didn't want the, you know, this down here by itself. So I went, and why not? I mean, there's no rule that says you have to have a border all the way around four sides. Sometimes I only do two sides. Then I would have done it the whole strip, you know, a whole strip of this, which it wouldn't have made me use any more designer series paper, because some of these things have math involved. They didn't tell you that you had to do math when you did card making. Well, you don't have to do math, but you do have to do math if you're going to mass produce. And I'm making 30, well, a total of 38 of these, right? So that's why I had to go and figure everything out. Okay, what if I made this 1 3/4 inches wide? How many can I get out of a page? How many can I get out of a page? 1.5. Now, you know, I'm sure that there's places that you could look it up, but, you know, I do like to stretch my mind every now and then, not too much, and go and try to get, you know, try to get the most out of my cardstock. Because even cutting this very vanilla, you know, I mean, I have enough very vanilla here that I could cut it any way I want. However, that's not mindful. You know, that's you know, I want to get as many pieces as I can, because one day I'll be here and going, I wish I had another piece of very vanilla. Now, it's only paper. Don't stress over it. Don't stress over it. However, it is a good idea to go and think, because one way, if I cut it out one way, and I forget if it was this or the, I think it was the strips for this. If I cut it out one way, I got 16 out of a sheet. And if I cut it the other way, I got 18 out of a sheet. Well, alrighty then. Okay, does that make sense to you? Do you go and try to figure out when you're mass producing cards, or maybe you don't mass produce cards? You know, let us know. And so, you know, because maybe I'm telling you about something that is not applicable to you, and then I don't want to waste your time. So back to this. So now we're gonna take some snail adhesive, and of course, it's, you know, I've only got the fast fuse here, and that's overkill. That's okay. I've got my messy desk right behind me. This is the back of this. And I have to tell you, my husband thought that this was this looked like a football field. Sorry, I have to look at me. Good thing is with snail adhesive, you don't have to could I have cut that a little bit better? Maybe so, but you know, I'm gonna give this to my son-in-law. Now here, I went and you could use fast fuse for this end if you wanted to, because I'm gonna be putting more on here and I want it to all stick together. I don't really care. Either way. Now, here's a hint. Okay, so here we have, let's go in. Here's Karen down in Florida. Oh, and Brenda's down in 29 Palms. They have way more than 29 palms down there. Oh, good. Connie's over on YouTube, and she double checks too, and so, you know, that is great. Karen says, I try to consider how much paper I'm going to have to cut for multiples all the time. You know, and that's a really good practice to get into, because even, you know, I mean, even if you have a lot, you could go and you're going to be wanting it one day. So here's the other thing, and then here, Jeannie, she's like, I always make more than one of each card. You never know when you're going to need to run and grab a card from the emergency stash. Oh, isn't that great? You know, my friend used to go and make, she used to make an extra card, you know, like maybe she'd be at the end of a class and she'd make extra cards out of some unused parts, like maybe she had a couple extra pieces or something, and she would go and make them, and then she'd sell them over in the corner. So I thought that was great. Oh, Marcy said she's got an Excel spreadsheet. That's great. Okay, so one thing I want to encourage you to do is always double check. Never assume that you are putting this in the right spot, or else you're making a different card. So I'm doing this backwards to you. Fold over here. Then we're gonna put this down here. And when I'm putting it down, I'm just gonna make sure that the top, the bottom, and the right side or even, there we go. Now, one thing about snail is I could pick it up now because it's just barely down. But once I push it down like that, then it makes it a little bit harder. And if you do need to get it off there, then you can always take your heat tool and, buzz it with the heat tool right here just a little bit, and it will release. I'm not going to guarantee it with designer series paper. So make sure when you put designer series paper down, you got it right. Because once you press it, it's pretty much done. So what shall we do next? I'm going to do here. This is the corduroy Knight of Navy ribbon. And this stuff is awesome. Yes, this would be great for flannel pajamas. No, it wouldn't. It'd be awful small flannel pajamas. Now, I want to make sure that the ends are even. So the easiest thing would be to go and just trim it on the along the line. And then fold it in half. Fold it in half, and for the way that I always remember which way to cut my banner so that it's down like this at the end is to tell myself in the fold, so it's the folded end is the end that I do first. And just telling myself in the fold makes it to where I don't make a pointy end when I want a banner end. Could I have done that better? Hey, when you do this, and this piece is 4 inches long, I would make a rather deep cut, so I'm going to try that again. A real sharp, if you see it, it's a really sharp, I'm trying to put this over. There, it's a really sharp angle. See, and then it shows up more. And I was, golly, I think about the darndest things when I do this. This is 4 inches long. And let's see here. Boy, my little bucket is not agreeing with me today because I was over here creating last night at 2 a.m. So. So Connie, you're over there on YouTube. Where are you from? I don't know why, but YouTube always starts late. So here I've got one on one end and one on the other, and that's all I did last night. This is thick enough ribbon that it's not going to, it doesn't show where the glue dots are. And I did see, look at there. I'm facing it towards me, and I should be facing it towards you. It's thick enough ribbon so it doesn't show where the glue dots are. And I'm lining it up with the white, because if you put it underneath, then it's going to, wrap it around underneath, it's going to add more bulk to the card. So there you go. Now I'm going to get one of these. That's why I always have tops on my water bottles. I did this last one like that, but that's not the way I did the rest of them. See, the rest of these are all done like this. And I found that if I cut it hamburger-wise like this, right? And I believe I cut it, hold on, let's see here. They're 1 3/4 inches across. Then I can get 4 because, and the trick to this is to, so that it's easy to punch out. Hey, hi, Tony. I hope you're feeling good today. Hey, I hope you're all feeling good today. Yeah, I'm glad I am, because Wednesday was really interesting. So anyway, if you put it to where this little line right here is parallel to the bottom, it's going to be a lot easier to cut out. Now, this was the last piece left over, so see, there's no rule to it. Just get four on there, right? I think I cut out too many, but you need to, because when I do a swap, I like everything to be... See, look, I can do this. Now, this would be a nice time for me to have a camera over me, but come on, I have two. Boy, it's one of those things with quilting. measure twice, cut once. Okay, so there you go. This is the new punch. In a perfect world, I know what the name is. Hey, have those of you who I mailed out... mailed out your occasions catalogs and your celebration catalogs. Have you received them yet? Hold on. Do I have a... I have... Okay, this might be interesting. And I can tell... Whoa! See what happened? It comes in an envelope like this. Yeah, good thing the dog's not in here. See, now let's see, when I go and do the next one, let's see how it works out. Of course, I just put that thing down, and where is it? There, okay. Now, I'll bet you that Marcy knows the name of this punch. It's on the same page as the gentleman's stuff. Golly, and I had that here just a minute ago, too. Okay, so look at, I'm able to go and punch the next one, and it doesn't, because if I get it, if you punch, stamp it on here, so it's, this part is up too much here. Like if this is lower and this is higher, then parallel with the edge of the cardstock that you've cut, then you're going to have to cut this off in order to punch it out. So there is my tip that is really good. Okay. There's a couple tips here that I had never done before, and I hope you find useful. Golly, and you know that I had the stamp set here a minute ago, and there it is. The stamp set, truly tailored, but the name of the designer series paper has gentleman in it. So my husband, bless his heart, was taking this, and he cut out all these stitched, edged... ovals for me. It's the second largest, if I remember, and this is how I know I brought two of these. Okay, this is how I did them, and I find that it goes faster if you take your tops off as you're going along. Okay, I did it like this because it goes over the ribbon, see? And I'm not going to, sometimes I go and put like a mini glue dot there to attach it to the ribbon, but I don't really think I need that. And so I'm going to kind of center this on the card. So I've got, and that's not straight, but golly, what's a 16th of an inch between friends? And thank you, Karen. Okay, so this is halfway in between, right? And hold on, I got to hold this up. Yeah, it's still a little high. You know, my spatial intelligence, it works only in certain realms. Tailored tag punch, yay! That's what it is, Marcy, yay! Bonus points. Marcy is my right hand, oh yes. Now here's the other tip I'm gonna give you, and boy, this one, you know, I like using these dimensionals. Nobody makes dimensionals like Stampin' Up! Does. I can remember those great big ones that were really thick, and they were like that far apart on the sheet, and you'd have to pop them out. That's when they were called pop dots. And you know, if I was had a whole bunch of these, you know, around, great, but I find that I go through them a lot. And so so you could, you don't really need to put two big ones here. You could put two small ones here, but actually I'm really only going to probably put one small one just to keep it up in between, because you're just looking for something to keep it up. If you want to put two small, if I was doing it and sending it in the mail, I'd probably put two small ones, one here, one there. But you don't need to put two big ones because it's just not that big and doesn't need that much support. You want to put enough support so it's not going to bend over in the card, and you don't want to put, you know, and so these small ones, I mean, look at you, get a gazillion of them. So why not use them? Put a big one on either side and two small ones there. So there you go. Not a bad card. 30 minutes even with me stopping and talking, so that would make up for cutting time. And hey, you know, I hope you find this helpful. Do you have any questions? I kind of wanted to show a little bit of this. You think I can do it in 10 minutes? Because, you know, an hour is just too long for these. You know, you want to get stamping. I don't know about you, but I go to a Stampin' Up! Event and I want to stamp right afterwards. You know, I'm like, okay, hurry up. Get through that. I want to go back and stamp. So, and I will tell you, I'll do a little bit. I'm not going to do a lot. I'm not going to do everything, but I'll show you what I came up with. First of all, do not open these when you get them. These are the brushos. They're coming out. And do not open these when you get them. I'm looking for something that I had this morning. I'm just going to tell you, don't open them. Go and find a push pin like this. Go and buy some pushpins like that. Not necessarily fancy like this. This is just something that happened to be on my desk. And so I just took these. That's fine with me. I can see the colors. If you open them, they are going to just go all over like powdered sugar, right? As if you turned a box of powdered sugar upside down. So don't even be tempted. Don't even try it. So these are the brushos. They are really intense color. And so this is orange, this is red, and see, I put hearts on the red. There, put hearts on the red. I put a coin on the orange. Maybe that's a little old lady on that coin, don't know, but green would be that one, and then yellow, because yellow is not my favorite color except for sunshine, and that's not really yellow. And if it's your favorite, that's great. I didn't make these, Karen. Karen wants to know how I attach that to the push pin. I don't know, but they've been on my desk for probably 10 years. Okay, so whatever they used, it was really good. It looks like it's hot glue. It looks like it's hot glue. I'm not a hot glue. I don't know if you can see that underneath there. Right there. See that? So it looks to me like it's hot glue. So, golly, I started to get this stuff together just before, just in case we had time. And so we might do this tomorrow. Because, nope, it's a tomorrow thing. That's as far, As soon as I get off this, I'm going to find it's all going to be sitting there in a pile waiting for me because I got things together and I just put them together. And then guess what came on? And then I put them together someplace here. And that's okay because I'm trying to keep it to 30 minutes. So there's your teaser. And I'm going to show you tomorrow for sure. And I'm going to have more than one way because that way I have more time to do more things with it rather than I was just going to even try to only get one in there. And it's really lots of things. But whatever you do, remember, do the push bin thing. Hey, if you have any questions, now would be a good time to ask. And if you would like to be reminded in advance when we're coming on tomorrow, that would be a good thing to do is just go and type stamp in the comments and just nothing else, just stamp. And we will send you a Facebook private message about, you know, like 2 minutes before we start, give you some time to get in, to get me time to get started. And then you can be here from the beginning and we will play with these tomorrow, 1 o'clock. You know, hey, you don't mind if I do a couple in a week, right? You know, Wednesday for sure, but tomorrow, hey, let's do this. And one thing I do want to close with is before we, you know, I've been showing you all this new stuff. And before we go farther, I have to remind you that there is, hold on, I've got to push the right button here. There you go. There are still lots of things available in the holiday catalog that you might want to think about because I kept my favorite card this year. Well, I can't say that totally because I gave out a couple other favorite cards. And so, you know, when I said they were my favorite card, they were my favorite card too. It's kind of like best friends. I have more than one best friend. Don't you? You have more than one best friend, right? But look at things that are going away. This washi tape, this designer series paper, this stamp set. You don't even have to get the kit, right? And if it's still there, the foil snowflakes. I love the foil snowflakes. They're better than the doilies. And you can cut them. They're easy to cut. And so, I mean, these are all things going away. And I just love this. So, you know, if you want to get a reminder, just like I said, press stamp in the bottom of the, just in your comments. And I'm sorry, this only works on Facebook. So, you know, be sure to press stamp. And if you're not on my mailing list, hold on, let's get that dog. Hey, Cecil. My cleaning angel just turned the vacuum cleaner on. Here, I'm going to put this up there as well. If you are not getting our emails, I send out at least one free project every month. Plus, I advise you of specials that are coming and other tasty tidbits. So if you want to get on my mailing list, just type mail in the comments. And I'm going to go find that dog real quick. Hold on. Stamper! Is he in here? Stamper! Stamper, come! Stamper, come. It's like he couldn't hear me. Come on. He's like, oh, my appearance. Hold on 1 second. So if you, yeah, make sure, you know, when you do the stamp thing, it will definitely go and, when you do the stamp thing, it will definitely do our best to get a reminder to you just before it, we go on. He doesn't like this side. Make sure I got the right one. Yeah, he doesn't like this side of me. Yep. Oh, golly. Yes, he is a multitasking dog. He is actually answering your texts even as you're sending them to us. He is such a blessing to me, and so are you. I have to tell you, it's been a great year, and I'm looking to make 2018 my best year ever. And you know what? I'm really more interested in making it your best year, because it's, you know, God's been very good to us. And Stamper's now, how old are you now, Stamper? He's 12. And considering that he eats like a goat, you know, I'm serious. He threw up rocks, you know, in the past week or 10 days. And he really had me concerned. And so, you know, just like he always licks my ear, he just likes those earrings. He wants to nibble one of those earrings off of my ear. So, you know, he's just a great dog. Except for he does shed. Not bad. But I shouldn't wear so much black. So I look forward to stamping with you again tomorrow, the same stamp time, the same stamp channel on Stamper Talk, on Facebook and on YouTube. And, you know, we're always over at stamperdog.com. And, hey, if you want to go and check out some of the things we talked about, the new stuff isn't here until the afternoon of January 3rd. That's what, next Wednesday, right? But we'll still be here at 1 o'clock, and by then, that stuff will be available. But if you want to get some of this cool stuff that you won't be able to get later, because, you know, this stamp set, it's called Watercolor Christmas, and it is just awesome for making quick Christmas cards. God bless you, and thank you for hanging out with us. You know, this is not going to be the last one for this year, so make sure you're here tomorrow. See ya! Thank you.